Andrew McCart, IFL TV in association with MTK Global. I'm here in Holy Town at the MTK Scotland gym. With me, I've got Tyrone McCullough. Tyrone, how are you? Seems like you've had a great Christmas according to your Instagram stories, but...
but too good to be honest, but it's always the same with me at Christmas time. I go off the rails a bit. It's my favourite time of year.
I think I've seen one story where you rocked up at the pub and none of your friends were there, but you still made a whole story about it. You still had bought yourself a pint. What was that all about?
It was Christmas night and no one was going to the pub. I was dressed as Santa and I thought, fuck it, I'm going ahead anyway. Sat with my friend's dad and had a few pints of him just.
Legend, mate. Absolutely legend. Well, let's just get back to the business end of what you do. Is you're a professional boxer.
Yeah.
And drinker.
Part-time professional boxer.
Again, Taylor, last year it was a good year for you. I mean, you fought in Belfast twice at the tail end of the year against Joe Ham as well in the summertime and then another good fight. You've got yourself worked your way up to a world ranking in WBO.
Yeah.
When you out next, are you looking for another big fight coming up?
I don't have a date confirmed just yet. I should hear within literally a week or so, but I think for now it'll just be a six rounder maybe to ease yourself back in there after Christmas. But and then towards the middle of the year, summertime, August, I won't play massive fights. I know my team are doing their best to get me them, and I have confidence that they'll deliver.
Again, I think you're 14 or 13 maybe in the WBO, is that right?
You be behind 13,
yeah. 13 in the WBO. Are you going to make an assault in that governing body?
It'll probably be the smartest way to go for now, but because they're the one I'm ranked with. But you know, I could go all routes. I'm easy. I'll fight anyone, and I've called out all people. You know, I've called out TJ Duhine before, so he's Irish. I'm Irish. So I'd love that to happen, but I don't think he's too keen on it.
Well, again, I was going to touch on that because he's obviously going to fight a unification against Daniel Roman. I think that's true. But again, the Duhine fight will be a great fight. You're both with MTK.
Yeah.
If you keep winning, TJ keeps winning. Can you see that fight happening at the tail end of the year?
I can, definitely, because as you say,
right, we're
both MTK, so it makes sense to keep the belt in the camp, so why not? But I don't call him out because it's probably the wrong term to use. I said as after I won the WBO European title there that I would love to fight him because we're both Irish, and you know, it makes sense to get the fight on. There's never been an all-Irish world title fight, so why not? And and then there's no malice, no bad feeling in it. I've seen someone mentioned this in a comment in Facebook, what all Irish fights we'd like to see this year. Someone wrote Tyrone McCullough and TJ Duhine, and he went out of his way, and mailed the one and says, oh, delete that comment, that's ridiculous, he's way behind me, he's too inexperienced. So now I don't like him.
Right.
And you know what, even if he does lose the world title, still embarrass him, so...
Would you give him the fight? Again, let's just say, I said to you, if you keep winning and he keeps winning, you just need to keep climbing them ranks. Maybe get your shot at the world title.
100% doesn't necessarily have to be him. I just thought it would be good because I love to see anyone Irish doing well. Countrymen, brilliant, but obviously I would love an all-Irish world title fight to happen because it's
Belfast, history. Would you like that in Belfast?
Belfast, Derry, Leash if he wants it even, I'll beat him anywhere.
Oh, but then Lowen, don't you go, would you do that?
Oh, of course. You'd only get about 10 people in it though.
I don't know, I've got a big stage on the high street, you know that? Again, how was the training camp going? You've only been back, you were with Derry Matthews down in Liverpool, but then you moved up with Danny Vaughan, so again, you've only been here a week, but how are you finding it?
It's my first week here, but I've done parts of my training camps here before, and I love training. That's what was the only reason I moved. You know, I don't have a bad word to say about Derry Matthews or George Vaughan, they done brilliant with me, but it was tough being on my own. You know, I was doing my two sessions a day, and I was finishing up at about 1 or 2 o'clock, and the rest of the day just sitting in a hotel room by myself. I have a lot of respect for Derry and George, but my mates were up here, and I thought it was the right thing to do.
Well, it must be good because, like, I'm going to do a gym tour with Danny probably next week. I'm going to get Danny to show me this part of the gym that we're setting him all the weights and then upstairs with the ring, and then obviously what people don't know is there's literally another house attached to this building where you all live.
Yeah, you
know,
just next door.
So what's it like having, living like 2 steps away from the gym and having all your mates there? Must be good, is it?
It's handy, you can just roll out of bed 10 minutes before training, throw your gear on, start training. No, but it's, you know, it's an ideal setup. It's, look around, it's brilliant. So it is a boxing gym upstairs, normal gym down here. As you say, you live next door, where for your best mates, what more could you want, Nick, for a training camp?
Who's the most annoying one then of all you here? You've got Tyrone McKenna, Sean McComb, Sam Maxwell, Paddy Barnes.
He's right there. Wee Martin Clifford. No, I'm always joking. they're all good to love with, to be honest, but things might change when my weight gets a bit lower and they're all getting takeouts and I'm sitting starving.
That's what I was going to say, because it must be hard for like these guys. when you're all making weight, how can you all live together and all that sort of stuff?
You do start.
Paddy Barnes is probably the grumpiest man when he's not making weight.
He's the most angry man ever. He's never happy.
So what's it like that you're going? Are you looking forward to that stage?
I know it's just part and parcel of it. Your weight comes down, your mood starts to come down with it, so it does, but I have a long way to go to get to that stage.
Talking about weight, how is your weight?
It's not great. It's the heaviest I've ever been. Well, the heaviest I've ever seen it.
Disclose how much you're weighing at the moment?
11 and a half stone.
And what do you fight at?
8 stone 10.
Listen, it's hard work. I'm sure you...
I don't know where it's going to go to, but I always make it end up, and... to be honest, it's my own fault, as you've seen, I enjoy myself out of camp, and so that's why when I do have to lose the weight in here, you know, I will not complain about it, I know it's my own fault, but I get to put the head down and get the job done. I'm probably one of the hardest trainers.
Is it hard to make yourself for yourself, or is it?
It's very, very difficult, and it won't be long until I move up a weight, but I'm going to, as you say, I'd love to get a world title shot first at this weight, and that's what I'm aiming towards.
So what kind of fights are you aiming for this year? I mean, you had two huge fights. Was it 25 times you fight last year?
Three.
But again, two big shows in that. You fought in the... Did you headline the one in the...
Yeah, I fought in the mixed undercard. They won the Celtic title, and then I headlined my own show in the Titanic in Belfast.
So what are you aiming for this year? You want much bigger fights. Is there anyone in particular you're looking for out there in the rankings, or just something, anyone that's above you in the rankings?
I'd love to fight TJ if we can get it on as possible. I know he's... I don't blame him, because if that fight with Daniel Roman does happen, why not take that? It's probably going to be massive money, so it is, and why not go that direction? But this is just... what I want, and I would love to get it on.
See, when I speak to some Irish fighters, not even just Irish fighters, like Jamie Conlon in particular, sometimes called Frampton, when they talk about you, they always say they would hate to fight you. Why is that? What makes you... What is it with your style that makes people not want to fight you?
I don't know, it's just apparently I'm so unorthodox. Like, growing up in the Irish team, I was always called the novice, because of the way I boxed. Like, what's he doing? He doesn't know what he's doing. But then when I got on sparring, people just struggled to land a punch on me or land anything clean at all, and just to crack up. Even I remember fighting opponents and I'm losing the plot, like, and especially when I won my European medal, the boy got suspended afterwards because he started wrecking the place.
Really? Because you frustrated him?
But I don't know exactly what it is.
I've seen you fight. I've seen you fight Joe Hammond. I was there. I've seen you fight at the Titanic Centre. So I can see how you're doing it, but I don't understand. Like, I'm not in the room with you, so I don't know how frustrating it is. But every time I speak to these guys, they're always saying to me, "I would." There's one person I would not like to fight if I was fighting again, or there's one person I would not like to face. It's Tyrone McCullough. That must be sort of... Is that a backhanded compliment?
Maybe a common way, a bit of a jive, but it's working for me so far. You know, I'm undefeated, so let's say, Sally.
Again, is there any aim of defending that Celtic title if any of these fights don't happen, these bigger fights?
Not really. Like, I'm done, not done, but I like to see myself above domestic titles now, do you know what I mean? I've even turned down, as you know yourself, I've turned down the British title 2 or 3 times last year. It doesn't interest me at all.
Uh-huh. Well, the European then, would that be something you would aim for?
I think the EBU European title is held by an Italian now, I don't know his name, but if that's on the table, I'd take that, no problem.
But 2019, what can fans expect from you coming into the tail end of this year? I know it's just January, but... Again, it's a long year ahead. You've got a great team behind you in MTK. You're now with Danny Vaughan. So what can the fans expect?
Well, I know they've got big plans for me. As I say, obviously my next fight might be a 6-rounder, nothing too big. But after that, you know, massive fights, big titles, and hopefully stay undefeated and put myself heavily on the world scene.
And Sean McCombe fought in Boston. Would that be a dream of yours to fight in Boston one day?
Oh, anywhere. It's a big Irish population. You know, I love it, and I would love to fight anywhere with a good Irish population. New York, Boston, get me there.
Is it safe to say that TJ Denny's the guy you're after?
100%. Especially after his disrespectful comments. It's nothing but nice and nice calling him out.
Nothing but nice. Well, again, Tyrone, this is probably the first of many, because I only live down the road, so you'll be seeing a lot of me, so get used to my face. I won't be on that running machine with you anyway. So, Tyrone, keep up with the Instagram stories.
Thank you.
Thanks very much, my man.
Cheers.